This project has been talked about for near a century in York. I mean, this goes back to the Olmsteds, who are, you know, the landscape architects by which all others have been measured in the early 1900s.
And the creek belongs to everyone. Water belongs to everyone.
What we actually did was look at census data to determine what are our opportunity enclaves, basically what areas of the city could be most impacted by investment.
Public infrastructure in our community is an asset for everyone. So we have lots of private property in any given downtown or city, but there's very few assets that the entire community can enjoy.
We have to remember that our creek is a flood protection. It protects all those investments that we're making with public and private dollars.
So in this case, the infrastructure is stormwater management, it's flood mitigation, and so the Codorus project actually meets a number of our goals for the city while creating a commons that people can come to.
This project has a lot of complexity and detail built into this, and certainly the size and scope of it. You're looking at environmental improvements, infrastructure improvements.
So the infrastructure that we build should last for generations, and it's beholden on us to ensure that whatever we create is cared for in perpetuity.
So both economically, psychologically, this really could improve our city, and it could be the beautiful centerpiece of the city that it once was.
And now to have a project team in place, to have a governor that is willing to bring this across the finish line, to finally, 100 years later, after this was first studied and those original drawings show very similar to what we want to do today, to bring it across the finish line and make the Codorus that public improvement that we've always wanted it to be. Thank you.